Jupiter, named after the Roman king of the gods. It lies between the four inner rocky planets and the three frozen gas giants beyond, and it's by far our solar system's largest planet.
Jupiter is the king of the planets, and that's because it is the biggest of the planets. It has a storm on it that's actually four times bigger than the Earth itself, and it's been raging for hundreds of years. It has dozens of moons, this gigantic magnetic field. Everything about Jupiter is just huge. It doesn't do anything small.
If you were looking at our solar system from afar, you'd look and you'd say our solar system is made of the Sun, Jupiter, and assorted rubble.
This huge planet contains the evidence to our solar system's formation, to its evolution, and to its eventual demise. Jupiter is a world of vital information. If only we could delve into it.
In the Roman myth, Jupiter, the god, drew a veil of clouds around him to hide his mischief, and that's to some extent what's happened when we look at Jupiter. We're seeing not the surface of a planet, but the edge of a cloud.
This cloud of gas hides Jupiter's deepest secrets.
One of the big mysteries of Jupiter is what's at the very center, what is its core? And this is something that we actually don't know yet.
But scientists know what's happening inside Jupiter enables it to have so much influence.
If we want to know more about what's going on in this king of the planets, we're going to need to be able to part those clouds and peer inside.
Simple physics informs us its massive atmosphere is the stuff of nightmares.
Because it's a gas giant, the atmosphere, as you get deeper into it, just gets denser and denser, and the pressure gets higher and higher.
From the cloud tops to the planet's center is 70,000 kilometers. It would be a flight that would take 3 days, and a journey that would be hellish. And scientists know, because they tried.
The Galileo probe orbited Jupiter for years, looking at the cloud tops of the planet and the moons that orbit it. But at the end of the mission, they decided they could do one more scientific experiment.
On the 7th of December, 1995, NASA's Galileo spacecraft dropped a titanium probe into Jupiter's atmosphere. It broke through the cloud tops at over 170,000 kilometers an hour.
Even though Jupiter looks calm and serene from a distance, as you get closer, you realize that there are ferocious winds, there are lightning storms, and there are pressures that would crush any instrument.
The planet is 1,000 times the mass of the Earth, and that means as you go inward, the pressures and densities become very large.
The probe sensors revealed that hydrogen made up 90% of Jupiter's atmosphere. Temperatures of over 150 degrees Celsius and winds gusting at 640 kilometers an hour. It was hotter and more turbulent than scientists had ever imagined. After descending for 152 kilometers, just 58 minutes after entering Jupiter's atmosphere, the probe vaporized, leaving the majority of Jupiter's mysteries out of reach.